A year ago, I announced the launch of the Disruptive Technology Strike Force. In partnership with the Commerce Department, we at the Department of Justice set out to achieve a major national security priority, to strike back against adversaries trying to steal our most powerful technology and use it against us.
It is actually quite remarkable to think that 1 year since we started this strike force, we've been able to gather so many people to mark this 1 year anniversary from the government and now also from the private sector.
We're in the middle of a shift where it's these nation state actors that is posing the sort of most important and sort of long-term challenges to our national security. And so what does that mean for all of us? It means that one dimension of that threat is their attempt to obtain sensitive U.S. technology in order to modernize their militaries to such a degree that they're able to overtake ours through the powers of this powerful advanced technology, and that would disrupt the balance of power in the world.
We've charged actors who have engaged in building procurement networks to illicitly obtain semiconductor technologies that were going to Russia. We brought cases involving U.S. tech companies that were the victims of trade secrets and theft of intellectual property. We've charged China-based defendants who are seeking to acquire drone technologies that end up in Iran and in Iranian drones.
We came here to share our concerns with you. We really think and try to find the way how to limit the power of our enemy, how to limit the power of aggressor. And they try to steal all, what our colleagues said before us, all possible technologies to make them stronger.
Over the last year, the Disruptive Technology Strike Force has made great strides in neutralizing threats posed by our adversaries. And I want to be clear, we will not stop. No, we're just getting started.